we see a variety of plants around us. Do you know that there are more than 2.5 lakhs of plants around us? Well, these plants, they are difficult to study if we don't classify them. And for the sake of classifying them, we have to put a criteria. So first of all, we can broadly divide plants into two main categories, and these two categories are called flowering, and the second category can be non-flowering plants. Now you might be wondering that what sort of plants do not flower? Well, there are a few which we will see now. So first of all, the flowering plants, as the name says, these are the ones which have flowers. On the other hand, of course, the non-flowering plants, they do not bear flowers. Some of the common examples of flowering plants can be rose, mango, hibiscus, and many more. Coming to the non-flowering plants, these are some lower plants usually, and we say that some of the examples are mosses and ferns. So this is the broad category of classifying the plants. The next way of classifying the plants is on the basis of their size and the nature of their stem. And we can divide such plants like herbs, shrubs, and the last one would be trees. Okay, now what is the difference between these three? Let's have a look and observe. So like we said, we have divided the plants on the basis of size. So firstly, when we talk about the size of herbs, we see they are very small. Usually their height is less than 1 meter. Talking about the shrubs, they are like medium sized and their usual size is around 1 to 3 meters tall. Next is the trees. The trees of course are pretty tall and they are generally more than 3 meters tall. Coming next to the nature of the stem. In herbs we see that they are very soft, so we will say that they are green, they have a tender stem and they have very few branches. Next is shrubs. In shrubs we see that their stem is hard but not very thick. Their branches arise near the base of the stem itself. Next, the trees. The trees have hard, brown and thick stem. Their branches are present on the upper part of the stem. Let's have a look at some of the common examples of herbs. These are grass, tomato, wheat and mint. Next is shrubs. Shrubs can be hibiscus, lemon, rose or pomegranate. Next are the trees. Of course, the tall trees. The first example is mango, neem, gulmohar and peepal. You can also figure out in your surroundings like which plant you can categorize under herbs, shrubs and trees. Now there can be a third way of classifying plants for some different category of plants. For example, we would say that there are some plants which creep on the ground. Okay, they basically follow the surface only. For example, like in strawberry, such type of plants, they are called creepers. Okay, they are called creepers. Now in opposite to these creepers, you can see that there are some plants which climb up to a support. And since they are climbing up to a support, like in this grape vine, you would call them climbers as they are climbing. So till now we have seen different types of plants. We have divided different plants into different categories. We have seen that the first type of classification can be on the basis of flowers. So the plants which bear flowers, they are called as flowering plants. The ones which do not are called non-flowering plants. Second, on the basis of size and the nature of stem, we have divided them as herbs, shrubs and trees. Lastly, there are some different types of plants. The one which creeps on the surface are called as creepers. The one which climbs up to a support are called as climbers.